Vicki and I want to welcome you to this joyous occasion that had a bumps tonight, but we're all here and hopefully nobody died. I did want to help you at least initially see this from Dave's perspective. We had a rehearsal earlier this afternoon, and that was really a testament to the rehearsal dinner tonight was really the first heat, and we're all looking forward to the main feature event tomorrow. Nikki, I want to thank our family and friends, the Rutherfords and their friends, for coming, for making the effort to be here, taking the time to be here to share this occasion with us. We really do appreciate it. I want to thank Charlie and Annette for their gracious hospitality. Wonderful weekend. I want to thank John and Linda Rutherford for making a generous offer to host this event in their backyard. And at times tonight, boy, even with the rain, I wish we were there. But the forecast was such that we really didn't feel like it was the right or safe thing to do. And so we moved here. And I really do want to thank Mike Holzberg, Alex's friend, who really made it possible for us to move this event last night. And nothing that happened tonight was a reflection of what Mike really did help us here. So we want to thank Mike. I'd like to offer Dave and Allie the goal of that their parents have enjoyed together. Charlie and Annette have been married for 28 years. Nikki and I for 3 years. And I don't think any of us are slowing down. I certainly hope not. We have many great memories of Dave meeting Allie, falling in love with her. Two things stand out at the very beginning. Dave and a group of UVA students, including Allie, went to a convention in Detroit. And after that convention, Dave came back and called his mom. He said, "Mom," he said, "I can't believe she flirted with me." So, Allie, it was very successful, obviously. The other thing that it's amazing they sort of got through was the first time Nikki met Allie, and it was the second time I met her, was on a 13-hour car trip to Rochester, New York for a Baja competition. And so Allie's trapped in the car with us 13 hours up and 13 hours back. She's still marrying him. So.
It was a long car ride.
I want to propose a toast to Dave and Allie. I want to welcome Allie and her family into ours. I want to say how fortunate we are that Dave and Allie found each other. And I understand that one of my duties for tonight, and hopefully it's one that we carried off better than a couple of the ones earlier, is to offer some sage advice. So I want to do that in the words of the poet Ogburn and Charlie. To keep your marriage brimming with love in the loving cup. When you are wrong, admit it. And when you are right, shut up. Today, Allie.
Well, I guess it's my turn. And I certainly don't have a long speech because I'm smart enough to know don't call attorneys. He's a professional lobbyist who brings his own teleprompter with him. I'm not going to give a speech. I'm just going to get up here and just, I think I can speak for the four of us. How lucky and blessed we feel. But I have it on good authority that on Dave's Facebook page, he wrote something like this. I knew I was marrying the right gal. Now he looked up and said, look at that idiot in the F-150. His bumper modification is blocking his turbo engine.